right, all right, all right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from beautiful Portland, Oregon, out here on the West Coast. We are excited. Again, highly, highly, highly respect you guys for watching. You don't have to. Comes out of your way to come out here and see this. I love that. And if you guys are interested in more of it, I do a Tuesday night live stream every Tuesday night. Throughout the try to do it throughout the whole year, try to keep it consistent, but definitely throughout the regular season, it's absolutely outrageously fun and exciting. If you guys want to be a part of that, just let me know. Send me a link. I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, SportsChat503. You can find that if you need to, and let's chat it up. It is getting very close, right? We are 10 practices in, I think, for the Duckies. The AP was released today, so we're going to talk about the AP a little bit. Give a little bit of shout out to the Olympics. We hadn't talked about the Olympics. I've been in a little bit of transit. I've been working at the beach. I've been doing some other stuff. I got projects here. I'm in project mode. You know, dads, man, we always got something to do. We're always working, man. It's either we're working at our job, or we're working on a day off, or we're working on a vacation, or I mean, you go to a, how about the dad move? You go into an Airbnb and you look at, you all of a sudden you're like, I could fix this if you guys want me to real quick. So I had a major malfunction with my plumbing this morning. That sucked horribly. Shouts out to the plumbers out there. You guys are the real MVPs. Let's go ahead and break this thing down. AP came out today and is exciting. Oh, tomorrow we're doing, I'm sorry, this is a Monday night. Tomorrow we're doing the live stream with Scott Reed. And Scott Reed is an absolute legend. Rivals, absolute stud. So definitely got to check that out tomorrow. That will be tomorrow, 5:30 on the Pacific Coast time. Okay, let's talk about the AP. The AP gets released today, and it's pretty much what you expect it to be, right? There's no real surprises here. Georgia 1, Ohio State 2, but Oregon 3. You know, for us old school fans, we don't expect Oregon to be respected on that level. This year could be different. We're all kind of saying the same thing. This year could be different. What if everything actually comes true this year? What if the Ducks have a magical season? Oh, baby. But again, I like to do basically where you're taking a look at kind of like a rough estimate. I don't really get too deep into the, I guarantee this is going to happen. You got to play the game, man. I've coached long enough. I've played long enough. I know, just like any of us know. Got to play the game here a little bit. So let's see, let me get the pen out here, organize my thoughts. Georgia 1 is no surprise at all. They're going to have to get past Clemson an early shot there. You know, Clemson is the only thing, Clemson, Florida State, Miami, they're the ones hanging on that ACC. ACC's in a really tough spot this year. It's going to be really interesting to see how they react. Georgia feels like they're the team to beat in the SEC. Ohio State and Oregon, that's going to be a great matchup because they see each other in the regular season. I did not expect Oregon to be at 3. I thought Texas was going to be at 3. They're a blue blood. They had a great year last year. They get to the national championship or the college football playoff. I thought they had a great look at it. I also would always think Bama is going to be in that. Bama's at 5. You got Ole Miss at 6. Really interesting. I like the pick of Ole Miss. A team that's really been on the rise, really great with the transfer portal. They're going to have a tough run of it because they always do. Their schedule is always the thing that's going to get them. But I'm excited to see them. I like that, you know, I've seen people say Ole Miss could be somewhere almost at 11-1, maybe a 10-2, all the way down to like bowl eligible, 6-6. I've seen both. So I love that. Notre Dame's always going to get the love, right? Because they're a team that can do things that no other school in the country can do, which is recruiting any school that they want to in the entire country. And, you know, they're a very unique. There's other schools that can do that too. Alabama, obviously. Georgia, obviously. Ohio State. Everybody can get the name recognition. But Notre Dame's different, and they have remained different because of that. Penn State at 8. I like Penn State at 8. I think Penn State should be respected this year. When they're talking about the Big Ten, it feels like, excuse me, guys, I've been working a little bit here. It feels like Penn State's not really getting respected. And I personally think that they are a great team because they've got that coaching consistency. And they've really identified who they are. They've missed out that close oftentimes They have a tough schedule as well. They've had to play a gauntlet most of the time. So it is what it is for Penn State. I like that they're at 8. That kind of gives them a nod a little bit. Michigan at 9 was surprising. I get it. There's a major step back this year. You got a new coach. You got this, that, and the other. But that's still a pretty good jump back. Still in the top 10, though. Now you've got Florida State. Is Florida State going to be a team like they did last year, where they ran through a fairly weak schedule? They had kind of an opportunity at the end there, but then the powers that be didn't even give them a chance to go. Obviously, this year, 12-team playoff, they're going to make it if they kind of run through it like they did last year, but they're going to have an interesting run. They start the year in Dublin. You like that game over in Ireland? I guess it makes sense, you know, when it comes to Notre Dame a little bit. Bring Notre Dame over there. But Georgia Tech, Florida State. we'll see. Mizzou at 11. I think that's awesome. And then you got 12, Utah. This is one where I think is pretty interesting because giving Mizzou that much love early on, I thought is incredible. Over teams like LSU, Clemson, you know, Tennessee was really good last year. Oklahoma, historical blue blood, right? So that's just pretty much rounding that out. I was really surprised by 12 being Utah. I do think Utah has a chance to win that Big 12. And they obviously have to get past some teams there. I think Oklahoma State is probably going to be their biggest threat in that conference. And you're always going to have to get through something. There's always something in that conference. Big 12 is going to find a way. Iowa State, maybe, you know, Baylor, you know. And at some point in time, you're going to have a run of it. And I do love the matchup of Utah and BYU. And then you have the end of the thing, which is Oklahoma State, Kansas State, Miami at 19, Texas A&M at 20, Arizona at 21. I love this. Again, as a former Pac-12 guy, I love to see it. Kansas might be one of those teams this year. Could be an interesting one in the, you know, I don't know what the hell's going to happen in the Big 12. I think the Big 12 might be more one of the most exciting conferences to watch in conference play because who the hell knows what's going to happen? It's a brand new year with a bunch of new teams. And you got a really interesting situation there. At 23, you got USC. They can't not put USC in there. At 24, they've got the Wolfpack, NC State. And then at number 25, they have Iowa. Now, I think Iowa should be rated a little bit higher. I think USC has a chance any year to be in the top 25 and should be recognized as that. But let's talk about these Oregon Ducks. Man, oh man, oh man, does that feel good to be at number 3? That's some respect from a team that has consistently under Dan Lanning improved every year. You saw the improvement in year 1 during the season, right? Then you saw the Holiday Bowl. Then you saw, if you were watching, for some of us, we could barely get there on a plane. Then you saw an increase. Then you saw that Fiesta Bowl. Now, the Holiday Bowl, I thought, was a really good matchup because at the time, those two schools felt like they were pretty equal, and it did come right down to the kick, right? In the Fiesta Bowl, it was a blowout, right? It was one of those games you probably shouldn't even have been played, to be brutally honest, but it was, and it had to be done. And you're going to get that in the 12-team playoff, too, with that 12th team. I do think, though, that the respect Oregon gets coming into the next year, because again, we all know what this looks like. This is a whole scenario based on television and based on matchups and getting early matchups that have high rankings and adding intrigue and all this other sort of stuff to it. Is it real? You know, the numbers speak for themselves. It's probably not going to be that real because again, we have to wait. Are they going to do something similar where they have the 12-team playoff thing like they had the BCS 4-team announcement halfway through the year or whatever, start having their own? This is all controlled by the media. It's all controlled by the powers that be, the cable companies, whatever. I'm not trying to be a conspiracy theorist, tin hat guy or whatever, but we all know behind the scenes they're pulling the trigger on all these matchups, whatever. And I think this is the start of all that by placing people in the right spot. It's kind of like what lane you're in as a race. I do like the idea that the Ducks are at 3. I just think that it comes with a negative spot. There's some negativity to it. Everybody expects you to be there. There's no nobody believed in us sort of conversations. And guys love the nobody believed in us. Guys love to be the underdog, right? And I'm going to show these people. There is no underdog right now. You're expected to win games. Now, are you expected to beat Ohio State? That might still be up for debate because Ohio State's ranked number two at the beginning. Ohio State is on a mission right now. Ohio State wants their crown back. They want to go King James like in the Olympics. Ohio State could be a team that could be a real problem for Oregon this year. And we talked about this. We had Juck on Bucks in here. I'll have other Ohio State guys in or whatever. We'll talk about this as this game goes on, or as this game gets closer, because, again, it's going to be the game of the year. But the Ohio State game is one of those things where I don't know if Oregon even loses that much from losing that game. If they're already ranked at 3 to start the year and you have that matchup at a top 5 matchup, which, again, that's what I thought was going to happen by October 12th. I didn't expect this to happen on week 0 that you were going to be ranked in the top 5, both teams in the top 5. I thought Ohio State would be there. I just didn't think Oregon would be there. I thought that they would have Texas there. I thought that they would have Bama there. I thought that they would have maybe Penn State, maybe Michigan, because Michigan coming off last year, maybe Florida State coming off of the undefeated team. I don't know, but part of it is because I'm an older Duck fan and I'm not as brash or brazen about where I think Oregon should be with their rankings. And but it is what it is, and I love it, so I'm a big fan. I do think, though, you can't overlook the fact that we're moving toward a system where you're trying to get these super conferences, and then you're trying to decipher who are the top two teams from each of these conferences. It's pretty easy to understand this. If you can be the third team, then now you're in the conversation for, are you going to be a part of the 12-team playoff or not? The top two teams are automatic. There's no question about it going forward. So you have to put yourself in these super conferences. You have to find your way to get there. And then once you get there, you have to win. And when you win, you have to put yourself in a position where you can be one of those top two teams, maybe one of the third teams. The fact that Oregon's doing that on year one is dramatic. It's like a movie. It's incredible. The recruiting's off the hook. The transfer portal is a very hot place to be. The brand is hot. We've got a fun mascot. We do other stuff that's different. You have the inflatable thing everybody was talking about. That's the kind of thing Oregon's bringing to the Big Ten. And I think a lot of eyeballs are going to be on it. In year one, you're going to have a very hot head coach who people know is going to stay there. They're not questioning. They're not going to question. Not going to go through that whole thing again. You already had the chance with Bama. It didn't happen. They're not going to question it. Then I think the fact is Oregon's going to have to win. And if they win all their games, except for maybe the Ohio State game, go into the Big Ten championship opportunity, or maybe in that conversation with one loss at the end of the year, and they've won all the rest of their games, and they only lost to one of the best teams in the country, you're in a very good conversation. You're in a very good place. So hopefully that's what's going to happen, and we'll see how it goes. Or Oregon wins out and goes 12-0. Or Oregon beats Ohio State and loses down the road. We'll talk about all those things. Again, plenty of stuff to talk about. All right, y'all. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Again, check me out on Tuesday nights. It's a very fun time. Tuesday nights, 5:30 to 7:30. If you can't make it, go to YouTube. Go to the live section. It's in a different area. You know, videos, live, shorts. I'm going to start to try to do shorts more, too. I don't know how to even work this thing out most of the time. My son, the executive producer, he'll try to help me out with that. But if you're interested, Tuesday nights, 5:30 to 7:30 Pacific Coast time. Thank you so much for watching Sports Chat 503. It's always...